You may have heard the term LNP floating around for about the past 2 years, which stands for Lipid Nanoparticle. And the name is quite self-explanatory. It's where we encapsulate a drug in a lipid shell or a fat shell to help deliver those drugs to our bodies, tissues, or cells. Now, this research has been ongoing for more than 20 years in the nanomedicine field, and that's because sometimes drugs are very difficult to get into our bodies. They can be negatively charged, or they can be hydrophobic, meaning they don't like water, and we're mostly made of water. So we need efficient delivery systems to get those drugs where they need to be. Now, lipid nanoparticles are made of lipids, typically four types, mixed with some type of drug. In this case, I'm using an example of nucleic acids, like mRNA. It uses a microfluidics device to mix those lipids and those nucleic acids into this encapsulation system. So now you have your mRNA inside of an LNP. That LNP can then be administered to a patient, which allows for an easy delivery of that drug to cells. And that's because cells are encapsulated in a cell membrane, which is typically made of fats. Now, those fats are able to fuse with the fats from the lipid nanoparticle through a process called endocytosis, bring in that drug, and then deliver it where it needs to go. Now, lipid nanoparticles are made of four types of lipids, which are cholesterol, which is around 35 to 45% of the total LNP, ionizable lipids, which is the most important part of the LNP, which is around 50%. And that's because those ionizable lipids are positively charged. Now, that positive charge is able to interact with the negative charge of, say, mRNA to help bring it into our cells. And typically, there's around 100 to thousands of different ionizable lipids that are screened to find the right one that's going to work for the drug of interest. We also have structural lipids that represent around 10% to give those LNPs that spherical shape, and then PEG lipids, which are around 1 to 2%, which are on the outside of the LNP that help prevent that LNP from sticking to each other and instead having one giant lipid nanoparticle. Now, if we zoom in on what this composition actually looked like, we have our drug or our mRNA in the center, which is negatively charged, surrounded by ionizable lipids, which are positively charged. It then has some cholesterol and some structural lipids mixed in. And then on the outside, we have those PEG lipids to prevent, again, those clumping of the different LNPs within a syringe. Now, we've really heard a lot about these LNPs as it relates to the mRNA vaccines for COVID-19 made by Moderna and Pfizer BioNTech. But actually, LNPs were first approved in 2018 with the drug Onpattro, which is an siRNA drug, which we'll talk about in a different lesson. What this drug does is it allows for a targeted delivery to the liver to stop an abnormal protein being made called transurethrin. And this disease is also known as ATTR. So typically, these affects around 50,000 people in the world, and the life expectancy is less than 4 years. But individuals who are able to receive Onpattro get an IV infusion around every 1 to 3 months to help prevent this abnormal protein from being made. So essentially, it's stopping that protein from being made, rescuing the effect, and allowing those patients to live much longer. So LNPs are a hot topic right now, but they've really been in research for the past several decades, have been approved in other drugs in the past, and are only going to continue to improve to deliver better drugs to our bodies that we need.